Music. Till the beginning of 20th century, both dance and music were performed in private homes or in temples. Performing artists were looked down upon by the ordinary people who never associated with them. The colonial period witnessed the establishment of various gharanas, schools of particular arts, in the north and also surfacing of Madras as the center of Carnatic music in the south. Vishnu Digambar Paluskar and Vishnu Narain Bhatkhande contributed to the growth of Hindustani music in North India. In South India, Mysore and Tanjavur kingdoms encouraged music. The famous trinity of Carnatic music, Tyagaraja, Muthuswami Dikshitar and Shyam Shastri lived in the Tanjavur kingdom. Tanjavur and Madras slowly emerged as major centers for Carnatic music. During this period, Western music became popular in India. The era saw the introduction of many European instruments like violin and harmonium, which became indispensable in Carnatic and Hindustani vocal recitals. Several related forms of Hindustani music developed, such as Thumri, Tappa, and Tarana. This was the period when film and film music were introduced. Young men and women were very fond of film music. This period also saw the appearance of recorded music. Dance. Thanks to the efforts of many people, Indian dance entered the public domain. But the Indian families at that time looked down upon dance as they believed that girls might be mistaken for courtesans. Great artists made efforts to restore the classical dance to its traditional place of honor in India. Uday Shankar's great contribution to the Indian dance was his international experience and perspective coupled with an independent style. He was influenced by ballet, a type of European dance, and started a school at Almora in North India. Another Indian dance personality who came under the influence of internationalism was Rukmini Devi, founder of Kalashetra International Art Center in Madras. Bala Saraswati was yet another artist who emerged as greatest classical dancer of her time. Rabindranath Tagore contributed a lot to the development of Indian classical dance. He invited experts in different classical dance forms to study and perform in Vishwa Bharati University. Tagore himself evolved a new dance form called Rabindranritya. This dance form is basically a synthesis of various earlier dance forms. Devadasi dance was very popular in many temples of South India. Literature. 19th century was the period when the actual literary renaissance of Bengali took place. Michael Madhusudan Dutta and Bankim Chandra Chatterjee were the founders of modern age in Bengali literature. Madhusudan Dutta was the first Bengali poet to write in blank verse of Indian literature. The first truly romantic Bengali novel was Bankim Chandra's Durgesh Nandini, while the first Bengali novel of social realism was Pyari Chand Mitra's Alelar Gharer Dulal. The leading novelist of the age was Bankim Chandra Chatterjee, who gave the nation its national song Vande Mataram from his political novel Anandmat. Rabindranath Tagore wrote prose, poetry and drama. He also composed numerous songs including the National Anthem of India and Bangladesh. He won the Nobel Prize in Literature for his work Gitanjali. This was a collection of English translation of some of his Bengali verses. Premchand wrote in Hindi and Urdu. He addressed social issues in simple language. In the early 20th century, changes in style and content appeared in Indian literature. In addition to the verse form, generally used in earlier times, prose began to be used widely in literary works. The language used in literary works became simpler than before. Plays, short stories, and novels became very popular among readers. The themes were no longer based entirely on mythology, religion, and the lives of the rulers, but began to focus on social problems and political issues. Trivia. According to 2001 India Census, Hindi is the most spoken language in India. Press. The printing press did not exist in pre-British period. It was first introduced in India by Jesuits to print Christian literature. In the 19th century, the press started influencing people's lives and thoughts. the introduction of printing press in India was an event of revolutionary significance. The awakening and the growth of national consciousness among men gave rise to nationalist press. Newspapers like Sambat Kaumudi, Bombay Samachar and Amrit Bazar Patrika helped to fan the nationalist sentiments of the people. Different techniques played an important role in the colonial period. The first Bengali engraver was Ramachandra Roy, and his Anand Mangal was the first Bengali book to have engraved illustrations. Though in the beginning, printing presses were owned by the English, native Bengalis started their own presses in the late 19th century and started printing books with illustrations engraved on woods or metals. These cheap booklets depicted religious and mythological events or contained popular stories and children's texts. The invention of lithography revolutionized the printing processes throughout the world. The lithographic process was brought to India around 1825 with the establishment of the Asiatic Lithographic Press in Calcutta. Here, lithographic medium was used merely to make copies of maps and documents for government offices. Anand Prasad Bagchi and his associates established Calcutta Art Studio in 1876. It produced and sold lithoprints of religious and mythological scenes, portraits and alphabets which were popular items in the middle-class house decoration. Raja Rami Verma was the most successful artist in print art who established his own press, and his prints in oleograph became immensely popular all over India. Trivia: the first major newspaper started in India in 1780 was Hickey's Bengal Gazette. It was published from Kolkata.